Hi, I'm Rivkah of trYoga with Rivkah, and I had shoulder surgery. When I was preparing for my surgery, I went online to find more information on what I need to bring to the hospital, what will happen, what is the experience, and what happens when I go home and need to take care of myself, and what is the road to recovery. There are plenty of videos out there on what kind of physical therapy you can expect. Obviously, it differs based on person to person and surgery to surgery, but overall, the information is out there for you. But there was very little, if at all, information on things like washing your face, things like how do you eat and walking around and everything, all daily life. So this vlog series documents my experience pre, during, and post-surgery from about a week before the surgery until 6 months. There are no videos of me during surgery, but I'll give you a sneak peek of what it was like right before. Why did I have surgery? I've been prone to dislocations my entire life. When I was younger, I would feel that something wasn't right, not that I ever had words for it, and I found instinctively different exercises I could do that would ultimately strengthen the shoulder, it's such a hard word, and would give me more range of motion in the shoulder. Then I got older. In my early 20s, I had a full dislocation. Very interesting night. And since then, I've had quite a few partial dislocations and several more full dislocations. For the most part, physical therapy was an effective way of dealing with this, especially when I had my office job. I didn't really use my shoulder that much, you know, typing, of course, but in terms of using the full range of motion that my shoulder requires on a regular basis, you don't get that much when you are sitting at an office working on a computer. However, I then retrained as a yoga instructor. Now, yoga instructors use their shoulders heavily, and I noticed over the year and a half that I was taking my training and I was teaching up to 10 classes a week that my shoulder was becoming more and more unstable. I actually had a full dislocation during my yoga teacher training, and then a little over a year ago, I had back-to-back partial dislocations, one in August, one in September, and I never fully recovered from that. I had a lot of pain. I had my fascia got all screwed up. And since then, I just felt my shoulder become increasingly more and more unstable to the point where even lifting my arm up this high, I never did. It was always extra locked in place. I would never extend this high because I could feel the instability. Teaching 10 times a week just made it worse, and no amount of physical therapy would really be able to help that. So finally, I made the decision to get the surgery. I wanted to get the surgery in my early 30s because I had a feeling it was inevitable, and the earlier you get it, the easier it is for recovery. I went to an orthopedic surgeon who ran a test, and it turns out that in addition to having an unstable shoulder, I have hyperflexibility in the muscles there. No, I can't do contortionist things, but what it means is the standard surgery for chronic dislocations would not be enough. They couldn't just screw the muscle in place because the muscle would stretch out on its own. So he recommended that I do a surgery called Latarjet shoulder surgery. This has been done for many, many years. It's very safe, it's very effective, and the research reports back that it's a great option for people in my situation. So what it does is it takes a bone from the shoulder blade area, I believe, and it moves it forward, and it creates a hammock effect for the shoulder, for the arm bone. So rather than the shoulder being able to pop out, it creates an extra level of protection there. And this also is in addition to the screws in the muscle of my shoulder. Another thing they did was they took the head of the bicep muscle, which usually attaches somewhere around here, and they moved it lower. So it was very simple experience. However, recovery has been very, very interesting, and you'll see that in future videos. So I had many months to prepare for the surgery. At first, it was scheduled for March, and then thanks to the coronavirus pandemic, it was pushed off for a couple of months and didn't happen until June. So this is my vlog series. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me. I hope you find the overall experience interesting. And if you are planning shoulder surgery, I hope that you gain some tips and information that will help you. Good luck.